Today we're going to take a look at Atkore's Flexicon connector box.
Oh, this looks fun.
It always is with Flexicon. It is, yeah. And we've got other videos on the channel where we've reviewed the flexible conduit from Atkore, and I recommend you check them out if you haven't already seen them. But today we're going to be looking at this connector box.
Yeah, so is it a conduit box? Is it an enclosure? Well, it's a combination of the two.
Okay.
But the flexi in this isn't necessarily just about the flexible conduit, it's about the flexibility you get with this enclosure system. So I'll have a little look at the key features.
Okay, let's have a look then.
So the first thing you're going to spot here.
Wow, that's a massive hole and there's loads of them in it.
Yeah, so that's how it comes. And then the case is how you plug those holes up. So the one thing you can do is put a blank module in, but then the rest is all down to these adapters for the conduit system. Now we've seen the Flexicon glands before for conventional boxes
yep.
that have threads on. This has got a special locking mechanism that mates with that box and that all-important O-ring seal.
Okay, that looks like quite a small conduit going in the end there. Is
yeah,
that so 16 mil?
That's 16 mil. So again, if we remember the Flexicon, it's all toolless. So to attach the conduit to the lock ring there, it's just a case of pushing it in. And then if you look on the inside, you can see it's right up against that blue O-ring seal. And this is IP66, IP67, 68, 69.
Okay, so in order to get to that, it isn't a case of you test at IP69, it gives you the rest of them. That's your test at all of those stages all the way through.
Yeah, a lot of people make that mistake. Yeah, it's IP60. Oh, it's tested underwater, so therefore it's okay in an IP66 application. That's not necessarily so, because the actual test procedure is very, very different.
But they're also UV resistant, is that right as well?
Yeah, so this, yeah, with that high IP ratings across that range, UV resistance, extreme temperature ranges, this is, yeah, a high performance, yeah, enclosure.
Okay, so we've now got a 16 mil conduit going into there with that large hole. Can we use it for any of the other sizes?
Yeah, we can, so I'll just plug that one in there. We'll look at how you do that.
Toolless as always, pushing
yeah,
and twist.
Push
yeah?
and twist, and then if I take
this,
34 millimetres.
Same style adapter, but obviously for
yeah,
a bigger
so
conduit.
Again, obviously bigger, so we can see the O-ring seal in there.
Okay.
Or the, yeah, you want to get the O-ring. And then you just, again, push the conduit in.
And this is 34 mil diameter, yeah?
Yeah.
Push that one all the way in.
And then you can see it's all the way up to the blue seal
there. It is, yeah.
Which means that's it, that's in there. That's not going anywhere.
Yeah. And that would fit in the same size hole in the box we were just showing for the 16.
And that just,
yeah, again. In push and twist.
Plugs in, that's it. So it's a toolless assembly.
I like that.
Great system. So I guess, you know, we've been messing around with this because we've got an application for it. And we've built one up that we're going to use on the channel. So shall we have a look at what we've done to assemble this and some of the other features?
We'll start off by fixing down our connector box. There's four external fixings. Why is that so good, Gordon?
Yeah, so you're not going to have to drill through the back of the box and risk damaging the IP rating.
And the IP rating here, we can see we've got a little O-ring.
Yeah, so this is a blanking plug. So again, these are very easy to put in. So you just align these marks here, push into place, and turn. So I'll use this coin that you found for us, Gary.
There's a story behind that. We don't need to go into that. So let's lock that into position. So if we see it from the other side, you'll see that locking mechanism. And we push and it just catches in, yeah?
Yeah, just that latch, yeah. If you need to remove it, you just push that down and then reverse the process to come out. So we're going to now assemble a DIN rail into the box. So we'll just shut this short length of DIN rail and then we're going to fix it to an accessory plate that goes in. Now you can have it raised off if you want to pass wires underneath, or another option is to put it a bit close to the back of the box.
That's clever, so that's both on the same plate, you know, in two different positions.
Yeah, so we've got the screw bosses in there, and then it just aligns with some tabs that are inside the box.
Do you have to screw that down, or is it held in place?
No, so that's going to be held in place when we bring in the glands into the box. So important that you put it in before the glands. But obviously, it's not difficult to remove them if you had to, if you forgot that. But so I've put that in there now. And then it's a case of just locking the glands into place. So just slot the Flexicon conduit into the adapter.
Again, no tool required, just push them into place. Exactly the same motion.
Push it in.
And we just hit lock into place, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, great. That's nice and secure.
Yeah, so. And then, yeah, the clips we've seen in the previous video where we looked at Flexicon, we love those clips.
I do, yeah. That's why it's in. So we'll do one on the other side. Exactly the same process, push it into position. Yeah, no tool, just lock it into. Yeah, very nice.
So this box is good. It's almost like it's a combination between a box and a sort of regular conduit box, really, as well.
So. And the diameter room we've got in there to work in is 110 mil, so it's plenty of room in there.
Yeah, so I've used that space to put in these DIN rail terminals.
Yep.
So again, just put the end blocks on. A lot of people forget to put them in, just to stop them sliding apart. So there you go, there's a five-way DIN rail terminal block in there. And then it's a case of just putting the lid on. So again, the lid, there's two little tabs for the lid to lock into place.
Okay, but what's going to hold the lid on?
And then you've got this separate ring here. So twist that on.
Okay, I can hear it ratcheting down. So that ratchets into position and it will lock.
That's an anti-vibration locking mechanism there. So once that lid's locked in place, to undo it, you'd have to push the little tab down.
I like that.
Then spin it off.
Okay.
So an alternative way of mounting the DIN rail, I can put them in the lid. So I'll just remove those glands there to remove it. Take my DIN rail off that mounting plate, but in the lid itself.
Ah, right, so
you've screw bosses, yeah.
Yeah, you're reversing the process now, so you can drop it the other way round.
Yeah, so depending on what you're wiring, that you might prefer to do it that way.
Okay, so just drop that in, and then we can obviously screw the lid back on. Yeah, lock it into position. Yeah, same process again.
Very easy to put that lid on. So now there's another option. So that's a standard lid. Here's an increased depth lid, so that again, you could have more wiring if you had the DIN rail terminal in the back. Again, you can mount the DIN rail on the back of there. But I'm going to use that to mount some 22mm push buttons, so standard industrial push buttons.
Okay, so we've got a lot more room now for the wiring loom in there by that extending the box.
Yeah.
Okay, that's
so again,
good.
22mm, so there's plenty of room for two push buttons on there, but you might have indicators or other things you want to add on there, so it saves you adding other bits to your system.
It's good that you get that extra room as well. So drilling these out then, we'll pop those in.
Yeah.
And we're going to use this around the workshop, aren't we?
We are. Stay tuned on the channel. Yeah, you will see this box. We have a purpose for this.
So yeah, we're not building it for the sake of it. We're building it for a reason.
Yeah, it's an up-down motion, but regular viewers might know what that's for, but stay tuned. So yeah, put the push buttons in, then click the switch modules onto the back. And then you can see that, yeah, plenty of room in there for wiring. Same lock ring on.
Is there anything going to allow me to either hold it in place or not lose that lid?
Yeah, so there's an additional accessory if you wanted a captive lid. So say you're up a height, you didn't want that lid to drop off. There's just this little mechanism here. So it goes around the tie base there and then screws onto the lid.
That's nice. So yeah, so when we take that off and yeah, it's only going to go as far as the strap.
Yeah, let's just give it a little test.
Yeah, and that comes out.
Again, so you're not going to lose your components. Nice feature.
That is a nice feature. Ah, security one as well, is this?
Yes, so obviously in a lot of instances you need to have a tool, to access the enclosure. So I'm just you can put a cable tie or a security tag through there and just to lock that lock ring in place.
The temperature range of this then is anything from plus 120 degrees down to minus 40?
Yeah, so this is a nylon material. It's got glass reinforcement, so it's a tough material.
Okay, nice little touch now. We can put labels inside there.
Yeah, a little labelling feature that's built in.
Ah, what's going on now?
So obviously we're using the Flexicon entries, but say you needed to bring a different type of conduit, fixed conduit, or bring a flexible cable gland in, the other flat sides can be used for that. So you get seven entries around the side, and there's also two positions at the back where you could also drill in to bring cables from the back if you needed to as well.
Again, we've got that O-ring on that to keep the IP rating on for the gland that we brought. But you just said a rigid conduit as well, yeah?
Yeah, that's another option.
Bringing in the flex.
Yeah. So again, important to pick the gland that matches the box, which is up to IP69.
Let's recap then. So where we've got multiple cables, it's so much easier to use the Flexicon than that traditional stuffing gland.
Yeah, I mean, we can use existing glands with this box, but for each type of cable, each one would require its own cable gland, more entries into the enclosure. And when you start looking at, you've got lock ring on this one, try to get your fingers in and tighten them. You may already have some wiring in there. It just gets a little bit fiddly, doesn't it, Gary?
Yeah, it becomes a bit of a challenge in order to get, as you're showing here, this lock nut on.
What I really like about this system is how quickly you can reconfigure it. So imagine you're on site, you need to add an additional circuit, Gary. So just unclick that blank plug and bring in the conduit. No need to drill the box.
And the issue there is if you were drilling into a box, you could damage cables already within the enclosure.
Yeah, so again, brought that big conduit in there, but perhaps things have changed. I need to quickly reconfigure it for a smaller conduit. Again, it's just that push the tab down, turn the gland out, it pushes out.
No tools required.
Yeah, really simple. No drilling,
Nice. That in. And what's good is because you're using the range from Flexicon, you're maintaining that IP rating, aren't you, of the enclosure, IP66, 67, 68, and 69.
Yeah, and the people forget a few things about IP ratings. Obviously, the weakest link in the system is the lowest IP rating. So we added those switches, they're IP66. So now that whole system becomes an IP66 enclosure.
Yeah, and if you introduce, say, a stuffing gland rather than using the Flexicon, you've got to make sure that O-ring's in place, and obviously you've got to work out what the IP rating of that part of the enclosure is as well.
Yeah, and you know, I mean, we've got a selection of glands here. Obviously, glands, sometimes the thread itself can push into the box and you start reducing your wiring room as well.
Yeah, that's one thing people don't think about, is it?
Yeah.
So as well as the IP rating, we've also got other things to consider about the enclosure, haven't we?
Yeah, well, people figure IP rating, yeah, that doesn't necessarily tell you its suitability for an environment. With this, with the external fixings, with that all plastic construction, it's built for exterior environments. You're not going to worry about corrosion where you might do on some other types of boxes.
I wonder if any of our loyal viewers have worked out what we're going to be using this for when we rehouse it over there. Just another little tip, it's going to go up and it's going to go down. That might be the last clue you need in order to work out what we're going to use it for. Yeah. Now, I can pick up all these parts separately, but can I get them in kit form?
Yeah, you can buy dedicated kits, through boxes, T-boxes, yeah, with different configurations of the size conduit, so you don't have to remember all the different part numbers. You know, I love a part number, but yeah, you just have to remember the part number for the kit. So yeah, that's a brown box here. Well, this is a CNB 110-kit 2. So that's a through kit.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah, that we've used here. Obviously, we had the full demo with all the options in there. But yeah, I think this is a solid piece of engineering. That's for those, yeah, demanding applications, yeah.
That's great. Inside and outside. Okay, we've got the problems inside maybe with humidity. Be fine when it's outside where we've got weather.
Yeah. Extreme vibrations, even got some rail ratings in there that not many of the eFIXX viewers are going to be putting it on moving vehicles, but if you were, yeah, they've got your back covered.
As always at eFIXX, we're interested in your comments. Have you guessed or worked out through the video presentation what we're going to be using this one that goes up and then comes down? You may find us using it on our live streams. Are you currently using any of the range of Flexicons from Atkore? If you are, leave those in the comments below. Are you thinking about using the Connecta box in the future, or you've already used it? Is there something in the range from Atkore that's an absolute gem and you want to tell the community about it? If there is, we may review it in the future. Leave all those comments below and we'll try and get back to as many as we can.